So what exactly is this Fermi paradox of software development, and what we can, should and must do to handle that, we are going to talk about in this video. So let's come back to the Fermi paradox of software development. Let me first talk about Fermi paradox. This paradox says that, you know, why we don't see life forms beyond Earth, okay? And this is a paradox because if life can evolve so naturally, it is highly likely that it has evolved somewhere else, but we are not able to see it, despite having millions of stars and planets and even more, that too in our own galaxy. Why we are not able to see the other life forms? It's a paradox. It's a Fermi paradox. Now, let me talk about how it is related to software development or whatever day-to-day software work we do. Okay. Now, I do believe that all of us have seen this scenario where we go ahead and say that, okay, this product, this software is bug-free because we have run all the test cases, all tests are passing, everything looks fine, we are good to go ahead with the production. Now, the Fermi paradox of software development is that, you know, with a code or software or a product containing hundreds of thousands of lines of code, we are not able to find bugs, and it is highly likely that there are multiple bugs which are still there after lots of testing. After all the testing, there will be bugs, but we are not able to find it. It is very similar to the fact that we have multiple planets, multiple stars, and still we are not able to find the life forms, but we cannot conclusively say that there is no other life form. Similarly, in a software, in a product with hundreds of thousands of lines of code, there is no way we can conclusively say that there are no bugs. There are bugs. The only problem is that at that moment of time, we are not able to find it. So in the software written by humans, there will be bugs. There are bugs, whether we are able to find it or not. Okay, so we cannot say for any software that it is bug-free. Let's stop using that phrase because it gives a wrong message, and I will tell you why we need to avoid using this particular term. Now, software having bugs is not a new thing, and you know, in most of the contexts, it may not be that a big problem. Okay, there are some bugs which we may not even find during the lifetime of the software. There are some bugs with whom we can live with it, right? However, there are some bugs which can cause serious damages. So software will be having bugs. It's just that we are lucky if we are not able to discover that during the lifetime of the particular software, or even when we discover, it is of lesser impact, but there will be bugs. Now, once we have this particular mindset that there will be bugs in the software, whether we are able to find it at that moment of time with all our testing, all our effort or not, there will be bugs because the kind of permutation and combination will happen with hundreds of thousands of even millions of lines of code. It is highly, highly unlikely that there will not be any bugs. Okay. It is the Fermi paradox. We are not able to find it, but we know it is there. Because no software developer, no product manager, product owner, or no CTO, no CEO will ever say that this software is bug-free, because even if it is bug-free today, there is no way they can guarantee that it will remain same during the lifetime of the product. Now, once we, you know, understand this particular aspect, once we, you know, understand and able to talk about that no software is bug-free, this is the place where our mindset change will happen. And now I'm going to talk about what we must do. Once we realize that the software is not bug free and we don't know what kind of bugs are there. There will be less severity bugs. There will be high severity bugs. So before, you know, giving any software out, we need to think about how to handle the failures. This is the most important thing which can change the quality of all the software around us. Okay. And this is something we need to talk about today, because today our lives are dependent on software. We are just giving our lives to the software to take care of it, despite the fact that there is no way to tell that that software is bug-free. So we need to understand that we don't have the technology now to make sure that the software is bug-free. Okay, and it may not be prudent or commercially viable to find all the small bugs that are there. But there is one thing which can be done easily today, and that is something all across, everybody across, all organization, every software organization must do, every programmer must do. And that is about handling the failures, handling the unexpected failures, okay? If you can handle the failure so that the catastrophic effect of the bug being occurred can be reduced, it's a great achievement in the whole software world. And you know, there are many techniques that are available today which we can make use of, like exception handling. And if nothing works, making sure that the software restarts, we can handle it. If some unhandled bug comes, the software can restart. Almost all programming languages out there has a sophisticated mechanism to handle, you know, even complicated errors. But in my 21 years of programming experience, I have seen that programmers, no matter how good they are in a particular programming language, they do not value the concepts or try to understand the sophisticated nature of error handling and sophisticated way of handling errors, okay? So even today, when a programmer learns about programming, their first preference is learning about programming, how to create things. Then second preference is how to test. Third and last preference is how to handle exceptions and errors. We need to change this. We need to make sure that we tell people that, look, handling exceptions, handling undefined situations and scenarios are extremely important for every programmer, for every software, for every product that is out there. And if we manage to do this, this is a huge achievement. And this is a huge achievement towards, you know, believing and, you know, trusting the software which is taking care of our lives today. So this was the Fermi paradox of software development and what we should do to handle that. So I hope and seriously believe that you are gonna share this video with all your contacts, all people doing software development, and start talking about this particular Fermi paradox of software development, and start talking about things like, you know, no software can be bug-free with the current technology, okay? So I do believe that this video was helpful to all of you. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.